Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and this is my video response to Pastor Mike. And he uploaded this, it's a very old video, I know, he uploaded this video titled Polygamy in 2008. So this is a really belated response. But I think that's okay because it's on YouTube, and our videos get archived on YouTube as long as YouTube doesn't take it down, or as long as we decide not to delete it ourselves. And as long as we remain like a user on the channel, I mean, it's archived. So I'm going to respond to it because I thought it was an interesting video. So Pastor Mike is, of course, just judging from this video, I can safely assume, I think, that he is a religious person and he belongs to the Christian faith. He does use the Holy Bible and he does talk about New Testament and about Jesus. So I think it's safe to assume that he talks about polygamy in biblical perspective, in Christian perspective. Here's the thing that always baffles me is religious people, if you belong to any of the Abrahamic religions, you know, Islam, Judaism, Christianity, Mormonism, if you belong to any of these religions, it baffles me that you would argue against polygamy. And use the Bible. You know, if you're using something else, anything else, I don't know, your sense of morality, your personal moral compass, or your personal experiences, or whatever, if you're using that, okay, I get it. But if you're using the Bible, it kind of it baffles me that you would argue against polygamy using the Bible, because it doesn't make sense. Because Bible doesn't condemn polygamy, ever. So here's, I think Pastor Mike makes two important points here. One point is about Adam and Eve, which I think is just odd. He's like, God created Adam and Eve, and this is the model, this is how marriage should be. One man and one woman. Adam and Eve is the model example of what marriage should be. That's the point. And he reinforces this point by saying that Jesus refers to Adam and Eve. And since Jesus refers back to this marriage of Adam and Eve, monogamy is the marriage that the Bible is promoting. And that's the marriage that everyone should follow. Polygamy was allowed in the Old Testament, and God allowed that to happen. But it's really monogamy that God wants to happen, that God is in favor of. So this is my response to that. First, how do you know that's what God wants? Because nowhere in the Bible does it actually say, I am God, and I instruct you guys to be monogamous. I prefer that you guys be monogamous. God doesn't say anything to that. Jesus doesn't say anything like that. Jesus refers back to Adam and Eve to talk about like this union between man and woman, and also to say that you guys shouldn't divorce. Jesus is totally against the concept of divorce. But that's totally another topic altogether. Also, using Adam and Eve as an example is weird. Really, it's just weird because, I don't know, maybe this is a hermeneutical flaw of mine. Am I interpreting the Bible right to say that in the Bible, God created Adam and Eve as the first and only human beings on the entire planet? Adam and Eve are the only people that exist at the time that God created them. There's no one else. Am I wrong to assume that? Did God create a lot of different human beings in the beginning, but only Adam and Eve are mentioned in the Bible? Or is it right to assume that Adam and Eve were the first and the only human beings that God created in the beginning? So if that's the case, polygamy is impossible because there's no other human beings to do polygamy with. It's not just model. This is not a model example of marriage. This is just the only possible way for people to marry because Adam and Eve are the only people that exist. Really. And in that sense, Bible not only condones polygamy, but it also condones incest. Because if the Bible is true and Adam and Eve were the only people that existed, then for the human race to propagate itself, it could only do so with incest. It's only possible with incest. That happens twice in the Bible. So, first with Adam and Eve, And then, of course, God decides to wipe out the entire planet with the flood, and Noah and his family are the only people to survive. And how else can human race propagate itself but through incest of Noah's family? There's no other way. And just for that, Bible condones incest. So using Adam and Eve as an example is kind of odd. Now, there's the point about the New Testament. Paul, in particular, likes monogamy. He actually says to other churches that, as religious leaders and as instructors, you guys should be setting an example for everyone. And the best example that you could set up, is to be kind to your wife. And it only mentions one wife. It doesn't mention multiple wives. But really, if you think about it, this isn't because Paul is in favor of monogamy. It isn't because Bible is saying monogamy is the best form of marriage. But because Paul is living in Roman society. The concept of monogamy isn't derived from the Bible. It's derived from Greek and Roman culture at that time. So it's Roman law. It's not biblical law. So Paul is living inside Roman society. So of course he would be monogamous. And he prefers that religious instructors be monogamous. But does he condemn polygamy? Does he anywhere in the Bible say polygamy is an evil sin to do? He talks a lot about sexual impurity, sexual immorality, and you shouldn't have sexual thoughts, and you should abstain from you should keep yourself clean and holy by not engaging in sexual activities. There's a lot of mention about keeping yourself sexually holy or sexually abstaining until you marry. I think that this is where people kind of try to, a lot of Christians have interpreted a lot of what Paul said to mean that you guys shouldn't have sex until you marry. I think that's a wrong interpretation, but that a lot of people have come to interpret what Paul said to mean that way. But it doesn't talk about polygamy. In a way that attacks polygamy. At best, the best thing you could do with the Bible is to say, Paul prefers monogamy, or that Jesus prefers monogamy. That's the best you can do. Because Jesus doesn't say polygamy is an evil sin. That's a sinful thing to do. And you should be stoned to death if you commit polygamy. The Bible doesn't do that. So if you're against polygamy, that's a good position to have. If you're for polygamy, that's a good position to have. It's a position to have. But using the Bible for that position is baffling. It doesn't make any sense. To be against polygamy, in my opinion, you can't use the Bible. You can only use this.